get you a little bit in order here. Since after 70 years of races going on here, we're closing down this year, let everybody know a little bit. Racing on Georgia Red Clay has a long and storied history, and a good bit of what is written here at Oglethorpe Speedway Park. In 1946, Donald Brewster purchased the land with a plan of constructing a racetrack. While the facility was under construction, Brewster suffered a heart attack and passed away, resulting in the project being put on hold and sitting idle for 5 years. 1951 rolled around, Joe Blunt acquired the land and all of assets on it, finished the project in March of the year, hosting a motorcycle race. In May of 1951, the first stock car race event was held. Johnny Parsons, the defending Indianapolis 500 champion, winning that race. During the 50s, Blunt hosted many races, and in 1954, the Oglethorpe Speedway hosted his first Grand National, which is now the Spring Cup, event won by Al Keller. In 1955, Lee Petty won the second Grand National event here at the Oglethorpe Speedway Park. Blunt traveled to maintain interest in the track, even hosting other events like horse races, but it was to no avail. Eventually, threw in the towel and closed the doors of the track sometime in late 59 to early 60s. Around 1974 to 75, Clem Burson started to clear the overgrowth here at Oglethorpe Speedway Park. In 1976, Blunt leased the track to Curtis Culver and Clem Burson to allow them the chance to try and restore the interest in dirt track racing. Culver passed away later that year, leaving the track in the hands of Burson. The following season, 1977, Emery Stone took over Culver's portion of the lease. In 1978, Emery entered the sole lease purchase option with Mr. Blunt. That gives you a little bit of history on the track, ladies and gentlemen. And here tonight with us, we have some of the Burson family. We'll be presenting in memory of Clint Burson in honor of his hard work and dedication in the reawakening of Oglethorpe Speedway Park after years of laying dormant. To say he cared more than some thought wise, gave more than some thought was needed, is an understatement. Clem's devotion will remain a great memory for many, with sincere thanks from the Stone family. And just so you know, folks, we got lots of folks here tonight from the Burson family. Marilyn Burson Snell is here. Son, I believe it's Tim. Grand Tim, Austin, and Preston. Bubba Burson, who's still. Continues, I see things. Still continues, Burson, body and towing. Donna Burson, Doxie, husband Riddle. Donna raised in the Palace up here at Oglethorpe Speedway Park. Riddle raised in late models. Mickey Burson Sanders and her daughter are here, and Nancy Sanders. So let's give all a big hand, ladies and gentlemen. The Burns family took it over and had it going until the Stone family got it. So I believe somebody's going to make a word or two.
Thank you all.
Let's get a big hand.